Hello? Hello. Let's start. My name is Andrew Lazarev, and as slides show, I'm working for Mirantis company. And for last year, I actively contribute to Sahara project, and recently became part of core team of Sahara project. And the whole year, the same questions was raised a lot of times. What is performance of Hadoop on OpenStack? And even on yesterday's Sahara presentation, the only question that was raised from audience was about performance. And during today's talk, I want to shed a light on this topic. Okay, I'll start with introduction and describe what I'm testing and why. After that, there will be results themselves. And the last topic I want to cover during my talk is data locality and how Hadoop users can benefit on it by running Hadoop on OpenStack. First of all, what is Hadoop? Actually, there are two correct answers on this question. It can be either the whole Hadoop ecosystem with the whole spectrum of Hadoop services, or it can be narrow meaning of Hadoop, only Hadoop core components that include MapReduce and HDFS components. This talk is mostly focused on the narrow meaning of Hadoop, so performance of only core components were tested. And why do we need Hadoop on a virtualized environment at all? The main driving force of virtualization is flexibility. It allows to use resources for jobs that are really needed right now. If user needs Hadoop cluster, it can just create it. If cluster is not needed anymore, user can just delete it. Some companies tries to utilize resources by running big Hadoop clouds and sharing it between a lot of users. But in this case, we need to provide a sufficient level of isolation for tenants. Hadoop wasn't originally designed to isolate jobs from each other. So, for example, for Hadoop 1, it is nearly impossible to isolate internal jobs from each other. The situation is better for Hadoop 2, but it is still not trivial. Running Hadoop on OpenStack allows to isolate tenants on a hypervisor level. And even if some job crashes the cluster, only this cluster will be affected, but not our clusters. When we talk with customers about Hadoop on OpenStack, they usually understand well why do we need Hadoop for test and stage environments. But still, we have concerns about production. And the main concern is what is performance. And during this talk, the main goal of this talk is to measure cost of migration from bare metal to OpenStack cluster. When I talk that virtualization gives more flexibility, I assume that there is a simple way to run clusters, modify existing clusters, and delete unneeded clusters. For OpenStack, there is a Sahara project that is data processing as a service. It allows to provision Hadoop clusters and run on-demand jobs on it. Sahara is starting from June cycle. Sahara is officially integrated project. It has pluggable architecture that allows to run different Hadoop distributions to create clusters with different Hadoop distributions and support different versions of Hadoop on it. Currently, Sahara supports Apache Vanilla plugin and Hortonworks Hadoop distribution. Both distributions support Hadoop 1 and Hadoop 2. It was also supporting Intel Hadoop distribution, but recently Intel unfortunately announced that they are closing their Hadoop direction and cooperating with Cloudera. Okay, what can be performance impact of moving from bare metal to a virtualized environment? First of all, there are some direct impact. This is I/O operations, network, and CPU impact. But also there is some indirect impact. For example, when we run Hadoop on bare metal, we need to tune only one operation system, actually system where Hadoop is running. For a virtual environment, we need to tune both system, host and guest. And this is much more complicated. Our impact is that hypervisor itself requires resources. For example, for OpenStack, at least one of nodes will be used as OpenStack controller, and we can't use its power for running Hadoop on it. Another example is that for compute nodes, we can't use the whole compute node memory because we need to leave enough memory for disk cache. Okay, now I'll describe what environment I was using. Probably some of you already noticed that Mirantis introduced Mirantis OpenStack Express service that can be described as a OpenStack as a service. So user provides parameters of OpenStack cluster he wants. And after that, he received fully installed and configured OpenStack cluster. And I think this is pretty awesome. And I was privileged to be one of beta testers of this service. And on it, I used a 20 nodes cluster. It nodes was with 24 CPUs. Actually 12, but with hyperthreading. It node was with 32 gigabytes of memory, 1 terabyte disk drive, and 2 gigabit interfaces, network interfaces. Note that the whole testing was for ephemeral storage. Using of external storage is out of scope for this research. In terms of operation system, I was using CentOS 6.5 for both host and guest systems. As OpenStack, there was Mirantis OpenStack. And on my system, there was a pretty old but stable QEM or KVM 1.2. And I'll say later why it is important. As network, there was a Natron with GE running on OpenVSwitch 1.10. And I'm listing this because performance of previous version of OpenVSwitch wasn't acceptable. For Hadoop, all tests were done on Hadoop 1. But I believe that results are applicable to any Hadoop version. For bare metal, I used all compute nodes, or the same compute nodes as for OpenStack. I didn't use OpenStack controller as Hadoop node to make comparison with OpenStack Fair. For OpenStack, I mostly tested on cloud with 19 nodes. And I'll say later why. Okay, let's switch to results themselves. So I ordered a cluster on Mirantis OpenStack Express, created a virtual machine on it, and measured disk write speed using a built-in DD tool. And it showed that disk write is 40% slower on virtual machine. And this is actually not something I wanted to see. But maybe Hadoop goes better. Hadoop contains a built-in drop to measure I/O operations, and I created Hadoop cluster, started drop to write 1 terabyte of data to the cloud, and it shows that Hadoop on OpenStack is 2 times slower. The first idea why this could happen is that one virtual machine can't utilize host resources, and probably if I spawn several virtual machines on the same host, probably performance will be better. But I tried, and performance even worse. But there should be some solution. It should be fixed somehow. And there is a disk cache modes parameter in Nova config file that controls how KVM configures disk cache parameters for guest system. By default, guest system is fully relies on host page file. And there is an option to enable disk write cache for guest systems. KVM doesn't recommend this option for systems where crash of VM can cause data loss. But in our case, Hadoop replicates data by itself, and Hadoop was designed to be highly fault tolerant. And it seems that in our case, it is pretty safe to enable this option. So I created one large VM per host with all memory dedicated to this virtual machine and tried the same tests. And performance disk write in this configuration is pretty the same for host system and for guest system. And what about Hadoop? Hadoop is a little bit slower, but not so drastically. 18% slower, and I think this already acceptable result. But one large VM on per host is not something how Hadoop on OpenStack is supposed to be used. Usually customers want to share compute node resources between different clusters, between different nodes within one cluster, and one large virtual machine per host can be temporal solution until Sahara supports Ironic for bare metal provisioning. But in general, this is not something how Hadoop on OpenStack is intended to be used. So there should be some other solution. As I said before, I used pretty old version of QEMU. I was using QEMU 1.2. But in later version, in 1.4, there was a new block device driver introduced, and Red Hat claims that it is 2 times faster on random write and gives significant performance benefit for our operations, like read, like significant sequent write. Mirantis OpenStack stayed on version 1.2 because version 1.4 wasn't stable when when it was tested. But currently, version 1.7 is available, so there is a big chance that all instability issues were fixed and new block device driver can be used in production. But I didn't have enough time to test it, so more testing is required here. Okay, let's switch to our factors that can be affected by virtualization. For disk read, HD Parm tool shows that cached read speed is pretty equal for guest and host systems. It also shows that buffered read speed is much better for a virtual machine. And this is expected result because when tool is running on virtual machine, host page file is used and operation system of virtual machine knows nothing about this. For Hadoop, read operations of Hadoop is a little bit slower than on bare metal, and performance impact in our I/O test is about 20%. As for network, I was using network with GIE, and performance impact in this configuration is about 6%. And probably it can be better if using VLANs instead of GIE. For testing CPU impact, I used built-in PJOB that is mostly depends on CPU. And test shows that performance impact on CPU is only 2%. So for calculation tasks, performance impact is minimal. Okay, that was impact of specific parameters. But what about real-like scenarios? In Hadoop distribution, there is a TerraSort job that pretends to represent real Hadoop workloads. It involves all kind of calculations, and since intensive write is involved, I enabled write cache in OpenStack and tested on configuration where one large virtual machine was running on each host. And for real-like workload, performance of Hadoop on OpenStack is only 6% slower than performance of Hadoop on bare metal. Okay, well, last topic I want to talk about is data locality. Hadoop can consider distance between nodes, and if Hadoop is installed, for example, on two data centers, then it is better to schedule job to data center where required data is located. So this can give us using this fact, we can benefit. We can get all benefits of isolation. For example, we can assign data nodes and processing nodes of Hadoop to different virtual machines, and they will be in different different virtual machines. On the previous slides, when I talked about network speed, it was related to speed between virtual machines on different hosts. On the same host, network speed between virtual machines is much faster. And it can be compared with discrete speed. So to demonstrate how running Hadoop on OpenStack can help with isolation, I used the same TerraSort example. And separated data nodes and processing nodes. And test shows that if Hadoop knows nothing about topology of a system, there is a significant performance degradation. But if we provide topology to Hadoop, performance in such configuration is nearly equal to a situation when data processes and processing nodes was running on the same virtual machine. Okay. So this research showed that on real-like workloads, performance of Hadoop on OpenStack is only 6% slower than performance of Hadoop on bare metal. And the main performance degradation is caused by I/O operations. And probably upgrade of hypervisor tools like QEMU will help with it a lot. Like upgrade of OpenVSwitch helped a lot with network speed. The main benefits that virtualization gives are flexibility and isolation. And isolation nodes in different clusters and for nodes in the same cluster. If you have any questions, you are welcome. That's all from my side. Thank you.
One question. Have you evaluated also Linux containers like Dockers and the effect on the I/O operations?
It was out of scope of this research, so I just don't know.
Okay, thanks.
I didn't try this.
Hi. First, congratulations. Well done. I have a question regard to the benchmark part. So you mentioned that you changed the numbers of the virtual machines in the host, right? So for different virtual machine size, did you change the, for example, Hadoop mapper and reducer numbers?
Yes, sure. Usually on OpenStack Summit, there are much more OpenStack experts than Hadoop experts. And there are a lot of technical details are not included to this presentation to make it more clear. So it's a good practice to run the same number of workers as we have CPUs. So.
Okay, thank you.
I have a question also. Did you find any performance changes or differences between tests that you performed with bare metal using physical disks versus the virtualized storage? If you touched that, I must have missed it. So.
As I said in the beginning of presentation, the whole testing was done for ephemeral storage. So I didn't test it with network storage. So. Volumes, NAS, so this wasn't tested during my research. Okay, If there are no questions, thank you everyone for attending.